everyone. My name is Mohammed Al-Haji. I was born and raised in Amman. I am an internal auditor for an international company, and I do products from garbage. And today I'm going to share my story with you and how waste changed my life and how it made me look at things from a different angle. It all started as a nice thing I used to engage myself in back in the early 90s when I was a kid. You know, each one of us remembers himself doing something he likes, whether it's playing with Nintendo or Barbie dolls. But for me, it was shaping designs out of waste. This is not me, by the way. I try to include waste in anything I use. And before I know it, I find my room is a junkyard. Funnily enough, I grew up to like it even more. I always wanted to build things out of waste. And at that time, my mom was the only person who could believe I'm a garbage artist. So I became known between my family and friends, the garbage guy, or better to say, I became known for my idea. So whoever wants to get rid of something, you will find it next day. You'll find it next day. Guys. Cool. You will find the next day standing in my room. Perfect. So you'll find the next day standing in my room. It's funny how our day-to-day livings generate so much waste. How we pile bags and bags of waste to be thrown away every single day. And here I was collecting the waste in my room and turning it into attractive pieces. So during my university years, I started learning and searching more about recycling, as the concept of practice was still new at that time. It was such an interesting subject written by people who spoke the same language as me. Unfortunately, people were from outside the country at that time. But I always wanted to put my spin on it, to change it in my own way. So here I started thinking of my first official product. And for no reason, I ended up shaping frames out of used wood. Adding the materials was not a problem. It turned out I can add anything. There are no rules, rules which are made by ourselves and our society. So once you're out of it, it becomes easier to think about. So I wanted feedback for my first official product, and I first started with my closest friends. And I remember the first feedback was, cool, next time we'll see you inside the garbage container looking for waste. So it was disappointing when people did not see what was becoming the most important thing to me. But then I told myself, don't wait for the right time or the right place. And I think this idea could be taught to others in a different way. So I discovered that this useful art could be inspired to others to unlock the creativity. So here I started thinking of teaching my useful art to children at school as a part-time job. And I remember the first time I walked into the class, one of the kids just asked me, "Are you doing this for a living?" So I told him, "Well, no, I have a job, but hopefully one day this will be my full-time job." And you know what he answered me back? Shulgaraf. But at the end of the semester, a group of parents and teachers came to thank me, as their kids are not only appreciating waste, but everything around them. It was a great moment. People are not only appreciating my art, but they understood the concept, and I was able to get through into the children. It was the greatest step forward I wouldn't have thought is possible. So I like the idea even more. I like bringing things back to life and use them to design products, furniture, and gifts. But still, I feel something is still missing. Because if I'm the only one shaping the products, then I'm the only one being educated. I was sure working in groups can make us happier to even accomplish larger and difficult tasks together. But working in a full-time job and traveling all the time with my company made things even harder. Not impossible, but harder. And to get the community's attention, I have to be there all the time, encouraging them to learn, read, and be creative in shaping waste into products. But then I told myself, don't wait for the right time or the right place. If you have the idea, which might help the world, starting with your own country, just do it now. And hearing the same feedback from everyone who got to see my pieces, which basically they will say, Muhammad, if you were in some other place, they would have appreciated your idea even more. This made me believe that my idea should be first implemented in my country, but nowhere else. So as a first step, I had to take out my bid in order to make a place for my new workshop. And my first project was corporate gifts, which was basically used, which was basically frames made from used wood and old magazine copies. Did I have the plan at that time? No, but I had the idea. So after I arranged with the carpenter, I met around 20 children who came to be called Ruwad Youth, which, by the way, they helped me a lot. And we started working with the frames. First class was almost a disaster. There was serious lack of coordination between everyone, including myself. Second class was more like shaping the designs and brainstorming. But I must quickly add that the third class was more like experienced groups working on a professional art pieces. I was looking at them as if I was watching a documentary, and I told myself, did I just make 20 children working on my idea? Did I just create this network between all of them? Seriously, it was a feeling of achievement, it was a feeling of achievement, and finally, the frames were great. I never thought they will come up with these designs, which, by the way, I believe they are even better than the ones I designed. So I was amazed with each product and piece we built. I felt there is a story behind each one. Many people used or even touched the materials which we are using. Many stories were left behind. But here we are, collecting all the stories together in order to make a scenario. I remember one day, I was sitting at the cafe where I had my exhibited pieces. And the waiter came to me and told me that there is one customer who wants to buy one of your products. And he wants to take it with him right now as a gift for newly married. I couldn't say no at that time. And it was my first wrapping gift. But the moment I just finished wrapping the gift, I knew that this piece, which I spent quite some time preparing and was standing at my room for a long time, is not my piece anymore. I will never ever see it again. Can you guys play the piece? It's after two slides. I will never ever see it again. So it was a weird feeling, as if I'm giving one of my children to a stranger, and he's going away with it. I just wanted to tell him, just forget about the money paid, give me back my piece, and I will let you go. But then I told myself, calm down, remember, this is your way of delivering the message, so let it go. Sometimes I walk in to my exhibition, not hiding, but taking a corner and pretend that I'm working. I just wanted to hear the feedback from people who comes in, and I wanted to make sure that they are getting the right message. At first, people who walked in felt in love with the cafe's furniture and accessories, which are not even part of my exhibition. But now, people who walks in falls in love with each piece and product, which means that the message was successfully delivered. Thank you. Now I know many people support my idea. My biggest fans are often those people who don't even know what the products are made from. I really enjoy watching the reaction on their faces when they first know what it is. So what's next? I'm planning to define a new product line, which is basically high quality products made from waste, and engage more and more people to work with me. I think, can please the slide after that. I think we need to open our eyes. We need to open our eyes. Just think about how many things are in our waste basket. Just imagine how much waste is around us. So instead of looking at it as something that you don't desire, try to think of it as an opportunity. Look how many options we have. How we can change our way of thinking. How we can save the environment. How we can enjoy the new experience and let the others enjoy it too. It's all inside this basket, and it's an infinite equation. We have many ways to reuse, to build other products from. And who knows, maybe we might end up never visiting the furniture store again. Well, maybe. After building recycled products for many years, I can assure you that we can use paper to build a country. How? We first need to look at it from a different perspective. The idea now is shaped under an initiative called Zawaid, which means waste in English. We have so many dreams for building products, furniture, and gifts. And who knows, maybe providing food from extra cooking for less fortunate and people in need. And also organizing awareness sessions by Zawaid students who were listeners one day, and now they are spreading the message to everyone. They're educating the community of waste usage and its effect on us if we don't treat it the right way. And I am sure those of you who are interested in changing the way of thinking and wants to connect stories and want to change their community will be the first to join. Who knew the little boy who shaped product into art pieces and turned his room into junk will be talking here at TEDx today? And who knows, maybe. And who knows, maybe one day this little kid will organize a TEDx event just like this one to talk about recycling and waste after TEDx approval, طبعاً. So finally, I would like to end with this thought. Let's appreciate what we have before we appreciate what we don't have. And you never know, it might have a better taste. That's my story. Thank you very much.